إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله. We praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whoever Allah guides, there is none that can lead him astray, and whoever is led astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is alone and has no partners, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as you ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul and created from it its mate, and scatter from them to many men and women. And fear Allah for whom you demand your mutual rights, and don't cut off relations with the wounds that bore you. Indeed, Allah is a raqib over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that He may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved the greatest achievement. Amma ba'idu, certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah, and the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen, and every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is a straying, and every straying is in the fire. How often have we heard this statement of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Indeed, the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen, and every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is a straying, and every straying is in the fire. I want to inform you today that not everything you see in the masjid is al-Islam or the sunnah. Not everything that you see the Muslims doing of what they think is worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Islam and the sunnah. But the Muslims are practicing, and we see in the masjids, bid'ah, that which is in opposition to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that which is rejected and not accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the message that we want to get across today. When you come to the masjid, I want you to think to yourselves, is my aqidah in this deen of al-Islam correct? Is the dhikr and the dua that I make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is it correct? Is the worship, is my wudu, is my salah, is it in accordance to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or am I practicing bid'ah that won't be accepted from me? Let's listen to this story from our Salaf al-Salih and hopes that this point might be driven home. قال عمر بن سلمة رحمه الله كنا نجلس على باب عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه قبل صلاة الغداء، فإذا خرج مشينا معه إلى المسجد، فجاءنا أبو موسى العشاري رضي الله عنه فقال: أخرج إليكم أبو عبد الرحمن بعد؟ قلنا لا، فجلس معنا حتى خرج، فلما خرج قمنا إليه جميعا فقال له أبو موسى يا أبا عبد الرحمن إني رأيت في المسجد آنفا أمرا أنكرته ولم أر والحمد لله إلا خيرا قال فما هو قال إن عشت فستراه رأيت في المسجد قوما حلقا جلوسا ينتظرون الصلاة في كل حلقة رجل وفي أيديهم حصى فيقول كبروا 100 فيكبرون 100 فيقول هللوا 100 فيهللون 100 ويقول سبحوا 100 فيسبحون 100 قال فماذا قلت لهم قال ما قلت لهم شيئا انتظار رأيك أو انتظار أمرك قال أفلا أمرتهم أن يعدوا سيئاتهم وضمنت لهم ألا يضيع من حسناتهم ثم مضى فمضينا معه حتى أتى حلقة من تلك الحلق فوقف عليهم فقال ما هذا الذي أراكم تصنعون قالوا يا أبا عبد الرحمن حصا نعد به التكبير والتهليل والتسبيح قال فعدوا سيئاتكم فأنا ضامن أن لا يضيع من حسناتكم شيء ويحكم يا أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ما أسرع هلكتكم هؤلاء صحابة نبيكم صلى الله عليه وسلم متوافرون وهذه ثيابه لم تبلأ وآنيته لم تكسر فوالذي نفسي بيدي إنكم لعلى ملة هي أهدى من ملة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أو مفتتح باب ضلالة قالوا والله يا أبا عبد الرحمن ما أردنا إلا الخير قال وكم من مريد للخير لن يصيبه إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حدثنا إن قوما يقرؤون القرآن لا يجاوز تراقيهم ويم الله لا أدري لعل أكثرهم منكم ثم تولى عنهم قال عمرو بن سلمة رأينا عامة أولئك الحلق يطاعنون يوم النهروان مع الخوارج أخرجه الدارمي وهو صحيح عمرو بن سلمة رحمة الله عليه from amongst the companions of Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله عنه and from amongst the tabi'un he said we were waiting at the door of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه just before Salatul Dhuhr we were waiting for him to come out so that we could walk to the masjid with him and then Abu Musa al-Ash'ari رضي الله عنه came And he's from the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he asks, did Abu Abd al-Rahman come out yet? And this is the kunya of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. So we said no. So he sat down and he waited with us. And to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu came out. And we all stood up to him together. And Abu Musa, he said to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu ma. I saw something in the masjid a little while ago and I opposed it. But alhamdulillah, I see nothing but good. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, what do you see? He said, if you live, you will see it too. I saw in the masjid a group of people who were sitting in circles waiting for the salah. And in each circle they had a man and in their hands were small pebbles. The man would say Allahu Akbar 100 times, and they would say Allahu Akbar 100 times. And the man would say La ilaha illallah 100 times, and the people would say La ilaha illallah 100 times. And the man would say to them, say Subhanallah 100 times, And the people would say Subhanallah 100 times. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, what did you say to them? He said, I didn't say anything to them. I was waiting for your position and your commandment. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, you should have told them to count their sins. And you should have guaranteed them that their good deeds would have not been lost. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he left heading toward the masjid, and we left with him. Until he came to one of those circles and he stood over top of them and he said, what in the world do I see you doing here? They said, oh Abu Abdurrahman, these are pebbles and we're saying Allahu Akbar and La ilaha illallah and Subhanallah and we're using these stones to count how many times we say it. He says, I command you to count your sins. And I will guarantee you that none of your good deeds will be lost. May the mercy of Allah be upon the Ummah of Muhammad. How quick are you to be destroyed and go astray? The companions of your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are around you in abundance. His clothing sallallahu alaihi wasallam has not even decayed yet, nor has his vessels been broken. And this is a statement from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu to show that we're shortly after the death of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I swear by the one whom my soul is in his hands, that either you are upon a religion that has more guidance than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or you all are opening the door to deviance. They said, we swear by Allah, O Abu Abdurrahman, that we only intended good. He said, how often does someone intend good, but he never does it? Indeed, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported to us, or narrated to us, indeed there will be a people who read the Quran, and it won't go past their collarbones. Meaning it won't enter into their hearts or their minds where they can understand it and practice it. And I swear by Allah, because I don't know, but I feel that you are the majority of those people that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was speaking about in that hadith. And then he turned and walked away from them. And Amr ibn Salama rahmatullahi alayhi said, and I saw the majority of the people were sitting in those circles, that they were fighting us with the Khawarij the day that they fought Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu in a Nahrawan. And this story we benefit that not everything that the Muslims are doing, not everything that we see in the masjid is al-Islam or the Sunnah. Rather, the Muslims are practicing things that have nothing to do with al-Islam. They are making a salat that wasn't taught to us by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. People are making wudu that wasn't taught to us by the Prophet of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. People have aqidah and beliefs that weren't taught to us by the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. People are making different dhikrs and du'as that weren't taught to us by the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Not everything you see in the masjid and not everything you see that the Muslims are doing is al-Islam. So learn your deen, learn the book of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and follow the way of the sahaba. Otherwise you might be practicing some bid'ah that will set you up for a punishment with your Lord and set you up for having your deeds to be unacceptable in the sight of Allah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst the people who adhere to his book and to the sunnah of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and follow the way of our salaf al-salih. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu amma ba'du. And this story of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu and his confrontation with the mubtadi'een, that there's many more benefits to it than just knowing that everything that the Muslims do is not al-Islam and the Sunnah, or that everything you see in the masjid is not Islam and the Sunnah. But al-Islam and the Sunnah is the book of Allah and that which has been authentically reported on His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, with the practice and the understanding of the Sahab and the Tabi'un and the Tabi'in and the scholars of this deen up into our times until Yawm al-Qiyamah. We also benefit from this lesson. If we listen to this story and reflect upon it, we see the virtues of hanging out with the people of knowledge and spending our time around with the people of knowledge in order that they might benefit us and educate us to the knowledge of this deen without burdening them. As we see that the Tabi'un, they were waiting at the door, but they didn't knock on the door to disturb him. But they waited till he came out so that they might benefit from his knowledge, the knowledge of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, the one who the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about him, رَضِيتُ لِأُمَّتِي مَا رَضِيَ بِهَا إِبْنُ أُمِّي عَبْدٍ أو كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ in this authentic hadith, where he says, I am pleased for my ummah that which Ibn Ummi Abdin, and this is the name of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, that which he is pleased with for my ummah. We benefit from this, the virtues of walking to the masjid. As we see the sahab and the tabi'een walking to the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to perform the salah. And you can't walk to the masjid unless you live close enough to the masjid so that you might witness the jama'ah with the believers and to gain the reward of that. We also see in this story the virtues of giving the affairs to those people who are in charge or those people who are more qualified. As Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, though he was from amongst the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the scholars of the Sahaba, he knew that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu was amongst the biggest scholars of the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he let Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu handle it. This doesn't mean that there's blind following in this deen. And it doesn't mean that there's a priesthood in this deen. And it doesn't mean that knowledge is only with a few of us. But this was from the etiquettes and the protocol of those people who we should be following to show that you should leave the people who are more qualified to handle the affairs because they are best fit to handle the affairs. We also see from this story that bid'ah, only the people of knowledge are aware of what bid'ah is. And that the masses of the Muslims could be unaware of bid'ah and they could be worshipping Allah upon that which isn't correct. As bid'ah, it has its roots in this deen, or the origin of it seems to be based in this deen, but the practice and when you do it is not based in this deen, and this is what makes it a bid'ah. As we see in this case, that saying Allahu Akbar and La ilaha illallah and Subhanallah is from this deen, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you must remember Allah the way it was taught to you by the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you could say Allahu Akbar and La ilaha illallah and Subhanallah and be punished for it if you do it other than the way it was taught by the Messenger of Allah Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like we see in this example. Rather, there are many examples from the Sahaba where they blame people for opposition to the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like in one of the examples we have mentioned before, when a man sneezed and he said, Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. And Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu or someone else from amongst the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam blamed him. And he said, are you going to blame me for saying Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah? He said, no, I'm going to blame you for your opposition to the Sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us when we sneeze to say Alhamdulillah. And he didn't say wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Not saying, just saying the dhikr or the dua or any other aspect of worship in this deen, it must be performed the way that it was taught to us by the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it must be done in the times that was taught to us by the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or it might be a bid'ah in this deen. Hold on to the people of knowledge. Hold on to the books of Islam. Hold on to the tapes that teach you your deen to make sure that you don't fall into this bid'ah like many of the Muslims have fell into, and then your worship won't be accepted in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes the issue of bid'ah can be tricky, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent people, alhamdulillah, who understand the Quran and the Sunnah of His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, so that they may explain to the masses of the Muslims that which is from al-Islam and the Sunnah, and that which is bid'ah, so that people might know the right way and they may leave off the wrong way. Be aware of falling into bid'ah, as it won't be accepted from you on Yawm al-Qiyamah. We benefit from this story, the virtues of following the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, "How quick are you to be destroyed when you have the companions of your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam around you in abundance?" Nowadays we have the narrations of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with us, as we have the Musannaf of Ibn Abi Shayba and the Sunnaf of Abdul Razzaq al-San'ani, and as we have the Sunan al-Kubra al-Bayhaqi or the Sunan al-Darimi rahimahumullah ajma'in, that carries the narrations of our Salaf al-Salih, like Imam al-Darimi rahimahullah, he brought this story from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. You see the virtues of following the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and their understanding and practice of the Quran and the Sunnah. We also benefit from this story that your intentions to do good is not sufficient by itself. Your good intentions don't make the wrong right. Your good intentions won't make the bid'ah the sunnah. You have to have a good, pure intention, and then you have to have knowledge of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the understanding of the Sahaba of the Prophet of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam wa radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. Your good intention is not enough until you have knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah along with it, as we see in this story. Learn the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Your intentions are not enough by themselves. Yes, you need your intentions, and they must be with every belief and every statement and every act of worship, but you must be in accordance with the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, or your good intentions won't be enough. We benefit from this story that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu uses evidence from the Quran to show that the people are not practicing this deen properly, and that there's such thing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us that there will be Muslims who read the Quran, but they don't understand the Quran and they don't practice the Quran. They only read the Quran and it's only parroting words off of their lips, but the understanding has not entered into their hearts, nor has the practice entered into their body parts. And this is why they are upon bid'ah, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had informed us over 1400 years ago, alhamdulillah. And we saw that those people, as we benefit from this story, we saw that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he explained that perhaps you are from amongst the people of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is referring to, because you're practicing the Quran and the Sunnah on other than the manner that it was taught to you by the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa radiyallahu anhum. And we saw from this statement of Amr ibn Salama rahmatullahi alayhi, that those people of bid'ah, they were the people who killed and fought the forthrightly guided Khalifa and the cousin of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa radiallahu an Ali ibn Abi Talib. And that this is the end result of practicing bid'ah. You think that making your wudu incorrectly is only a small issue. You think that making your salat incorrectly is only a small issue. You think that your incorrect aqidah is only small. The end result of it is fighting and killing the people of Ahl Sunnah. And wallah alladhi la ilaha ghayruh, right now in these times, the people from Ahl Sunnah are still getting many threats of death from the people of bid'ah. This is their way of the past, and this is the way of the people today. watch out in your worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Watch out in your dhikr and your dua. Watch out for your aqidah. If it's incorrect, one day you might be fighting the people of Ahl Sunnah and your opposition to the Quran and the Sunnah and the way of our Salaf al-Saleh. This is from the authentic narrations of the Sahaba of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wassalam. And there's many virtues in this story that maybe we can't even cover in just a short khutbah in Yawm al-Jumu'ah. But we hope that the point is gotten across, that not everything you see in the masjid is al-Islam and the Sunnah. And not everything that you see the Muslims practicing is al-Islam and the Sunnah. You better check out your aqidah. You better check out your dhikr and dua. You better check out the statements that come off your tongue. You better check out how you worship Allah by making wudu and making the salat and fasting and making the hajj and making sure that it's in accordance to the book of Allah and the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the way of the sahaba radiallahu anhum, or you might be upon bid'ah and dalala and your deeds will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will drift off to the rest of the deviant people, and then you will find yourselves fighting Ahl Sunnah. Oh Allah, we ask You to make us from Ahl Sunnah. Oh Allah, we ask You to save us from being from Ahl al-Bid'ah. Oh Allah, don't make our aqidah from the aqidah of Ahl al-Ahwa and Ahl al-Bid'ah. Oh Allah, don't make our dhikr and dua bid'ah. Oh Allah, don't make our worship of You bid'ah. Not in our wudu or in our salah or in our fasting or in making the hajj. Oh Allah, make all of our deeds in accordance to the Quran and the Sunnah. Oh Allah, make all of our deeds and our actions in accordance to the way of our Salaf al-Saleh, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, let us be mindful of this story. Let us get the moral of this story. Oh Allah, make us understand that not everything we see in the masjid is al-Islam and the Sunnah. Oh Allah, make us understand not everything that the Muslims are doing is al-Islam and the Sunnah. Oh Allah, we ask You for Jannah. Oh Allah, make us from amongst the people of Jannah. Oh Allah, save us from the hellfire. Oh Allah, increase us in knowledge. Increase us in wealth. Oh Allah, increase us in the Sunnah and decrease us in bid'ah. Oh Allah, we ask You for the good in this world and the good in the hereafter, and to save us from the fire.